There are billions of stars in our galaxy. Each star varies in terms of its mass, temperature, size, and luminosity. When astronomers started observing the stars, they found a particular pattern among them. So the Hertzsprung-Russell diagram is a scatter graph of a star's luminosity versus its temperature. The y-axis of this graph represents the star's luminosity, or indirectly its brightness, which increases with the increasing y, whereas the x-direction represents its temperature, which decreases with the increasing x. The alphabets written on the x-axis represent the spectral class. The O-type stars on the extreme left have maximum temperature, whereas the M-type stars on the extreme right have lowest temperature and red color. Now let us analyze the diagram. There are four main regions on the diagram: main sequence, giants, supergiants, and the white dwarfs. The long narrow band in the middle belongs to the main sequence stars. These are those stars which are producing their energy by fusing hydrogen in their core. Once hydrogen finishes in their core, these stars become giants. The Hertzsprung-Russell diagram tells us that in the giant phase, the luminosity of the star increases whereas its temperature decreases. Above the giants lie the supergiants. They are even more luminous than the giants. Some of the biggest and the brightest stars in our galaxy are the supergiants. When a star comparable to the size of the sun blows itself into a supernova, what is left behind is a white dwarf. The Hertzsprung-Russell diagram tells us that the white dwarfs are not very bright, but they have extremely high temperature. Our sun lies in the middle of the diagram. It's an average star on the main sequence. It will continue to burn hydrogen in its core for 5 billion years, after which it will exit the main sequence to enter the giant phase.